This is Doc Gab, and ito ang doktor ng kahayupan.
Doktor ng kahayupan, the series.
Hello, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I am Doktor Gabriel Comota III, although hindi pa ako sanay na tinatawag na Doc. And I am a member of UP Alpha Chiron Society. And I wanna be a small animal veterinarian. I'm saying I wanna be kasi I'm not yet practicing. Maybe sa start of 2022, no, I will be starting to work. And then, generally, I am an ordinary student na nakachinelas lagi and nakatira ako sa UP dorm. And then, in terms of the academics, I think a lot of people were surprised sa rank ko kasi I did not particularly excel naman sa academics. Although, hindi naman ako naging petics lang kasi I had a scholarship to maintain the scholarship. Yun talaga pinag-pray ko, pinag-aaralan ko, and the fact na kailangan umutang nila mama, papa para matustusan yung education ko, shows na I have to work hard, you know, to maintain the scholarship.
How do you relax amidst all the chaos in veterinary medicine?
The small things, you know, kain sa labas with friends, you know, I have the 28 and then rotation mates, madaming usually go out, you know, at night, or minsan pumunta sa nanonood ng movies, ganon.
What made you choose small animals as your specialization?
Actually, very late ko siya na-realize while I was studying for the board exam, dun ko lang na-realize na I wanna go into a small animal practice. Because I subscribe to a lot of vet stuff online, like VIN, clinician's brief, webinars, podcasts, and then I got interested into a lot of disciplines, especially internal medicine. So, I got interested into it and I wanna be part of that field.
What was it like entering the board exams? And on top of that, how did it feel like when you ranked first in the country?
Actually, hindi ako makapaniwala kasi after the board exam, inisip ko, ala, paano ako mag-aaral ulit? Kasi hindi talaga ako confident sa mga sagot ko. Although I did my best naman sa board exam. And the days after nung result or right after the result, medyo bittersweet sa akin kasi I am an introvert, and as an introvert, parang di ko na-enjoy
all the attention. It's too much. It's too much.
So, tumaas yung social anxiety, etc. So, but it was all worth it naman kasi proud yung family and friends, mm-hmm. yung mga kapitbahay.
How about the job offers now, Doc?
Madaming offers, and the offers are varied, you know, pero mostly sa small animal practice, sa mga clinics and hospitals. Pero, and I did not accept yung mga offers right after the results kasi alam ko hindi pa ako mag-work immediately. So, by January, I will be starting the working.
Yes. How difficult was it to study for the board exams amidst the pandemic?
Siguro, understatement na sabihin na mahirap yung board exam. But, it was a walk in the park compared to all the things that we have to go through to be in that exam room, in the midst of the pandemic. The anxiety, the uncertainty, 2020 pa lang, daming questions, paano yung thesis ko, paano kami gagraduate, may board exam ba? So, napakahirap for all of us. And ako personally, I was stuck in LD for months and hindi ko alam paano ako umuwi sa amin. And then the exam itself, yun nga, di namin alam kung mag-exam ba. ala, magkwa-quarantine ba kami? Magpapaswab ba kami? Ako, I took the exam sa Cebu kasi yun yung pinakamalapit. And then, pagpunta ko doon, I was swab. So, merong uncertainty sa isip ko, hala, paano kung mag-positive ako, hindi ako makakapag-exam, maka-quarantine ako sa Cebu. So, napakahirap. And then, pagpunta ko doon, nag-MECQ pa. So, sobrang hirap na ganong may anxiety sa ano na nafe-feel. And then the day before the board exam, pumunta ako sa exam center. And then sabi doon, hindi daw tuloy. Sabi ng personnel sa school, hindi daw tuloy. So, alam mo yun, may ngiyak-ngiyak na, pero slight lang by that time. And then pumunta ako sa PRC Cebu, and then sabi naman nila, tuloy daw. So, but in the morning, the day of the exam, pumunta ako ng 5 o'clock. Ako lang yung tao doon, walang ibang tao. So, by 5:30, ako pa rin yung tao. So, inisip ko, hala, baka iba yung venue. Nilibot ko na yung school. Pawis na ako, nilibot ko yung school. Hala, baka mali yung entrance, ganun. Pero by 6 o'clock, may dumating na mga naka-white. So, insert yung meme ni Robert Downey Jr. na kagano. So, I was relieved by that time. And then, naka-exam naman. Although, di natapos doon, you know, pagpa-uwi ko, yung barko na sinakyan ko, nasiraan. So, we were stuck for 3 days. So, stranded kami for 3 days. So, pero naka-uwi naman, fortunately. And then, pero, I think, yung struggles ko are small compared to other people who are, na nagtratrabaho, may binubuhay na pamilya, risking their lives in the midst of the pandemic, while, you know, habang nagre-review, habang nangarap na pumasa sa VLE.
How did you prepare for the board exam?
Okay, first is, how long did I study? I studied for 4 months. You know, yung study proper, as in, ano talaga, aral talaga na madugo. Pero before that, nagbasa-basa na ako. And then, gumawa ng reviewers, nag-summarize ng ibang parts ng Merck. Hindi lahat kasi hindi mo talaga yun matatapos yung Merck. And then, yung time na yon, yung before ng 4 months, dun talaga yung deep learning. You know, for example, I wanna study about the kidney. Hindi lang yung parts ng nephron, ito yung glomeruli, etc. Hindi lang ganun. I understood every part of it, yung mechanisms, physiology. So, I took my time. Siguro pag yung kidney, it will last for 1 to 2 days, no? And kasi very useful yung understanding, yung deep learning for smart guessing. Kasi madaming talagang lalabas sa boards na hindi mo talaga ma-encounter in life. So, maganda na you understand the principles of veterinary medicine. So, very useful si YouTube for that. What I did was 40% of the all the things that I reviewed were sample questions or questions that I made. And that is very important. Dami kong sagot na nakuha sa sample questions. So, 40%, siguro more than 1 month sa 4 months na ginugol ko for studying. And that is very important. Saan mo yung makukuha? Sa review centers, sa mostly online, madami rin. Ayun.
How did you keep your focus in preparation for the board exam?
Okay. Kasi nahulog yung cellphone ko sa balde na may tubig. Right? Sa pag-start ko ng board. So, ayun. So, nakapag-focus ako kasi wala akong cellphone for months. Nakapag-focus ako sa pag-review dahil nawala yung phone ko. And then, although I recognize naman na minsan talaga na lumilipad yung isip sa pag-review. And what I do is, I change the media. No? Nag-video ako, nagpo-podcast ako. I change the topic, I change the subject. You know, for example, you are bored na sa pagbabasa ng coagulation cascade. You know, try to podcast habang may naghugas ng plato, naglalaba no podcast about mga new techniques for gastric dilation of volvulus, mga fever, is it a good thing or a bad thing, mga interesting things na magbibigay ulit ng focus sa'yo.
Can you enlighten us on how you mentally prepare yourself days before and during the board exam?
In terms of reviewing, yung iba sinasabi na wag na mag-review no before yung board exam. And I believe na effective yun kasi yung iba as in pre-pressure, etc. So hindi nakaka-think ng tama. So sundin niyo yung suggestion na yun. Pero ako kasi parang I know myself. I studied until the very hanggang the night before, hanggang sa exam center, hanggang pagalitan ako ng mga taga-PRC. Uy, ba't ko pa nang may dalang reviewer? Ba't ka nag-review dito? So, until the very last. And then, the night before the third day, hindi na ako natulog. Nag-aral na ako ng hanggang magdamag kasi half day lang naman yung third day. So, inaral ko yung medicine and micro ba yun, yung last day. So, ayun, magdamag ako nag-aral, hindi na ako natulog sa third day. So, huwag niyo tularan. At the day mismo, I try to spice things up para maging ano mas masaya. Kasi I like eating and then nasa Cebu ako. So, yes. Bumili ako, nagbaon ako ng lechon, yung spicy and original lechon. And then, alam mo yun, may look forward ka after the exam. Yes. For example, nung first day, parang naisip ko, yung after ng anat, kakainin ko yung original lechon. After ng fisyo, kakainin ko yung spicy lechon. Yung may look forward ka after ng every exam. It was fun for me, relaxing. Dahil may look forward na masarap na food. I think, I suggest na you do something na magpaparelax sa inyo. Sa mga viewers na mag-take ng board.
Could you entertain us, Doc, and explain what are the stories behind these pictures?
I think si yung roundup nila na contest. Nag-third kami ata dyan. Masaya nga eh.
paano kayo nag-prepare para sa quiz con na to?
Wala, di kami nag-prepare. lang, pumunta lang kami doon. Naisip lang namin. Ayun, nanalo kami.
Alright, so next picture po natin, Doc. Ito po.
I think yan yung first surgery namin. Castration sa cat. Oo, nurse lang naman ako dyan. Masaya kasi though sobrang memorable kasi yung first cut na dinala namin nakataka sa bintana. Yung bintana mismo nakikita. Tapos hindi na siya nakikita ulit. Sobrang unfortunate na experience. Kasi nagtakbo-takbo siya sa buong sa buong surgery room and then palabas nga siya, hindi siya naka-uwi. Timbap pangalan ng cat. First time ata namin dyan sa Tabon, first like activity sa farm animals in tissue 1.
What are your thoughts about the online setup while studying veterinary medicine?
Actually, when people ask me about my course, sinasabi ko na it is the most interesting course and there are a lot of instances na you will really enjoy and madaming hindi boring na parts. Especially kung nasa field, especially kung nagjo-duty. I think that part of the course was taken away from students na go online class. And though hindi ko maisip, I cannot fathom how hard it is for you guys, for the people, for the vet students right now.
Any advice on how to find motivation during the online setup?
What I did was I tried to find interest sa course. If, for example, if you want to do poultry, if you want to do find interest and make it something that will push you to be better in academics, maybe, or in the course itself, find something that will induce passion sa'yo. Ako, I was very interested sa science mismo, sa medicine of the course. So, that's what I did, I like reading and articles about medicine. So, that's what pushed me.
What was your most memorable moment when you were a student?
a wildlife duty namin sa rotation. I was with my rotation mates. Shout out sa mga rotation mates ko. We did our wildlife duty sa Biodiversity Bureau sa Quezon City. And it was fun, no? For a week, andun kami. And we handled a lot of snakes, you know, every day. And imagine mo yun, sobrang saya, sobrang maraming sigawan, you know, maraming tawanan. And that was at the... There was a time na someone asked, you know, ala, saan yung ulo ng ahas? Kasi wala nang nakahawak sa ulo ng ahas. So, nagtakbuhan, sigawan. And then, I think si Doc sa yung nagtanong na yun eh. Tapos, at the last moment, si Doc Arnel yung last one na nakahawak sa ahas.
How important is it to have face-to-face classes in vet med?
Okay. How important? The feeling itself to be with animals, that is something that you need to get used to before you go to practice. The first time you see a goat, the first time you touch a horse or a cow, that's an important experience itself. Not really the procedures, etc. You have to get used to. And that is very important sa profession nyo, as a veterinarian. The experience and appreciation of animals that are in front of you mismo. There are a lot of sources online, you know, my Veterinary Information Network, and then you can subscribe to newsletters, clinicians brief, webinars, madami. Kasi ngayon ko lang na-realize, sobrang daming webinar, akala ko limited lang yun. Sobrang daming webinars na free, you know. But in terms of how you can go about it in an online class, I am not sure because I have not experienced it. And the only thing I can say is good luck. And I know you are having a hard time harder than we had. Kasi, you know, you do not, wala kayong masyadong, ano eh, parang ecstasy sa pag, kasi, you know, pag, oh, my goat, my cow, etc. And it was fun for us. You know, di ko ma-imagine na studying vet med without that. So, ano lang, sympathy for you guys.
Where do you see yourself in the future?
I want to focus on internal medicine. I want to, that's it. I want to serve the people of the Philippines, I guess, you know. Di ko pa masyadong na-solidify yung whatever I want. Pero I am very interested in internal medicine sa small animals. I've been reading a lot about it and I want to contribute in that field. So yun.
Do you have any advice to future board takers?
So the reviewers that I use, you know, ito yung partner reviewers that I use. So this is the first reviewer that I read every page. Dr. De Ocampo's Veterinary Manual, every page. This is very useful kasi may anatomy, may histo, may aficio, minsan may clinical patho, and sobrang ganda niya, very detailed, extensive, although may mga parts na hindi updated, pero maganda siyang starting point for studying. And although in the like 4 months ko na pag-aaral, I mainly relied on the review center reviewers. But it is important to vary your reviewers kasi minsan hindi complete, no, walang masyadong information about other stuff. And then other reviewers, Merck Manual, although sa Merck Manual may mga lay terms na wala, for example for tiger striping, zebra striping ng myocarditis sa FMD, walang term na yon sa Merck. Makita mo lang siya sa mga review centers and then sa notes. So it is important to vary your reviewers. And other stuff, mga VLE, Saunders Navle reviewers, para sa mga taong ngayong December, it is better you rely on the reviewers na gawa na. But the best reviewers are the reviewers that you made. For me, ikaw mismo gumawa kasi na-appreciate mo lahat. If possible, don't review alone. Although, ako noon, siguro mga first few months, naisip ko, kaya ko to mag-isa. And then si Doc Rox, nag-invite siya. Meron tayong review every Sunday sa Discord. So, di ko alam ano yung Discord by that time. So, ayun. I joined. And then, yung usually andun si Doc Gio, Doc Renee, Doc Rox, ako. And then, andun rin si Doc Kaylee Weevil. Siya yung second, nag-rank sa, ng second noong February ward. And she was there giving questions, sharing tips every Sunday. And we are very grateful for her. For also, she shared reviewers to us. And ano, sobrang grateful namin sa kanya na she was there to guide us kasi tapos na siya sa board exam. And I want to do that also to other people.
Do you have any Christmas or New Year's present for fresh graduates?
Hello, I want to share my reviewers. And my reviewers are in the form of Anki. Siguro mga ano yun. So ito yung link. I want to share my Anki reviewers. Siguro mga 4,500 flashcards. Although yung originally 7,000. Pero I cannot share yung mga other information kasi hindi akin. So before you use it, try to look it up in YouTube kasi medyo complicated yung Anki. Pero the only important thing naman dun is yung settings. No? Set it, gawa ka ng settings for yourself. And for example, naka-encounter ka ng isang question, what is the antidote for lead toxicity? Example, nakalagay sa flashcard. And then, pinindot mo, lumabas yung sagot. Example, may sagot na yon. And then, first time mo siya na-encounter, pwede siya iset mo na bumalik after 15 minutes. Kasi first time mo yung nabasa eh, so i-review mo ulit after 15 minutes. Or pwede mo siyang ipabalik after 1 week, after 1 month, after 2 months, kasi alam mo na yan siya. So, it is very useful in remembering stuff and re-remembering stuff. So, I wanna share it with you. Although, disclaimer, walang mga sources kasi ginawa ko siya 2 months prior before the boards kasi recent ko lang siya rin na discover. Ayun. Guys, if you have questions, siguro message the Vet Boards Review PH. That is my page. So message na lang if you have questions. You know, if you wanna make a group, you know, in which includes yung mga gustong mag mga examinees from different schools. Maganda sana yun. So you can post questions about, you know, specific questions about topics in vet. Maganda sana yun, no? Magawa kayo ng group. And involve nyo ako para I can share my answers din. Thank you for watching again. This is Doc Gab and this is Doctor ng Kahayupan.
Doctor ng Kahayupan, the series.
In partnership with
brought to you by the UP Alpha Chiron Society.